Mrs. Mills. My name's Andrew Duncan, and this is Earthquake, Tsunamis, Oh My. No, Earthquake, Tsunamis, Volcanoes, Oh My. And I chose to do my project on earthquake-resistant buildings. Did you know that 50 earthquakes hit the Earth per day and over 20,000 per year? But don't worry, only a fraction of these are strong enough to damage property. These are two of the biggest earthquakes in the last 15 years. The first one occurred in 2004 in Sumatra, Indonesia. There were deaths over 225,000 people. And the second one happened in 2010 in Haiti. Deaths soared over 300,000. Most of these deaths were caused by poor infrastructure and badly built buildings. And buildings without earthquake resistant things. Oh. These things are important because in the long run, they will save time, money, effort, and even lives. Because the next time an earthquake hits, these things will tremendously help your building. A common quote is, earthquakes don't kill people, fallen buildings do. There are a few barriers to having earthquake-proof construction in your country, place, or region. The first is money and economy. If you're worrying about where your next meal is going to come from, then you're not going to worry about how earthquake resistant your structure is. The second is corrupt governments. If your government is greedy and trying to build the cheapest building possible, it is not going to put earthquake proof features on. The third is education. If nobody knows how to build an earthquake-resistant building, then how are you going to do it? The first test I did for this was with Tinker Toys. Here's a model of it. This is the first model. It has no base, but the second model has a wide base. In this test, I'm doing no base versus wide base for buildings. For this test, I took the base of the building and I shook it aggressively for 15 seconds.